हेलो एवरीवन एंड अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन टुडे सेशन आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ल्ड सोलर टेक्नोलॉजी समिट ऑफ ISA जो कि रिसेंटली अनाउंस किया गया है बाय इंटरनेशनल सोलर अलायंस. ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ मोबाइल यूनिट जिसका नाम है धनवंतरी रथ. एंड ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सम गाइडलाइंस दैट वर इश्यूड बाय NGT नेशनल ग्रीन ट्रिब्यूनल टू वेरियस स्टेट फॉर द रेजुविनेशन ऑफ गंगा. So guys, do watch the complete session and spread the knowledge. तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं आज का सेशन विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 which is about the International Solar Alliance World Solar Technology Summit. So the question number 1 is consider the following statements with respect to the ISA and identify which of the given statements are correct. Okay. So let us first discuss about the news. So recently World Solar Technology Summit of ISA was announced by ISA that will be held on 8th of September 2020 on a virtual platform. And this summit will be there to bring the spotlight on technologies for harnessing solar energy more efficiently. Jitni bhi technologies are related to harnessing of solar energy, harnessing solar energy more efficiently, un sabhi technologies ko spotlight mein laya jayega in this virtual platform. Aur sabhi members ko praise aur sabhi members ko motivate kiya jayega for producing solar energy and using solar energy as an efficient resource for fulfilling their energy requirements. Okay. And under this session, there will be 4 technical session in 4 language, English, Spanish, French, and Arabic. And there will be launch of ISA journal on solar energy, jiska naam hai IJOS. This is very important, guys. Ye one mark mein pucha ja sakta hai. The ISA journal, jiska naam hai IJOS. And this journal would help authors to publish their articles on the solar energy. Okay. And if you talk about the ISA, so it's launch was announced by Prime Minister of India Narendra Modi and former President of France Francois Hollande on 38 November 2015 during the COP21 which was held in Paris in France. It is headquartered in Gurugram in India. And if you talk about the partners, so guys, in total there are 121 member states of ISA, out of which 67 countries have signed and ratified the ISA framework agreement. Aur ye jitne bhi partner countries hain, इसमें ज्यादातर कंट्रीज वो हैं जो कि ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर या ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैप्रिकॉन के बीच में लाए करते हैं. ओके, दीज कंट्रीज आर दोज विच लाए आइदर कंप्लीटली और पार्टली बिटवीन द ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर एंड द ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैप्रिकॉन. बट इसके अलावा जो ऐसी कंट्रीज है जो कि ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर और ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैप्रिकॉन में लाए नहीं करती है, वैसी भी कंट्रीज इसके मेंबर हो सकते हैं बट विदाउट द वोटिंग राइट्स. ओके, एंड देयर इज एन ISA असेंबली. एक ISA असेंबली है गाइज विच इज द एपेक्स डिसीजन मेकिंग बॉडी ऑफ इंटरनेशनल सोलर अलायंस विच कंप्राइजेस representative from each member country, and countries that do not fall within the tropics can join the ISA and they can also enjoy all the benefits as other members but with the exception of voting rights. Unke paas voting rights nahi honge. And jo ISA hai uska aim hai to lower the cost of technology in the harnessing of solar energy, deployment of over 1000 gigawatt of solar energy by the year 2030 and to mobilize more than $1,000 billion into solar power by 2030 in member countries. Okay. And if you talk about India's efforts, so government of India has allocated 5 acres of land to the ISA in National Institute of Solar Energy campus in Gurugram. And also India has released a sum of rupees 160 crores for repeating a corpus fund, for creating a corpus fund, building infrastructure and meeting day-to-day recurring expenditure of the ISA up to the year 2021-22. ओके, सो दीज आर द इंडियाज एफर्ट्स. एंड प्रधानमंत्री जो हमारे नरेंद्र मोदी हैं उनको चैंपियंस ऑफ द अर्थ अवार्ड भी मिला था. ओके, चैंपियंस ऑफ द अर्थ अवार्ड, ये आपने जरूर सुना होगा. प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी एंड जो फ्रांस के करंट प्रेसिडेंट, उस समय के प्रेसिडेंट थे इमैनुअल मैक्रोन, उन दोनों को चैंपियंस ऑफ द अर्थ का अवार्ड दिया गया था क्योंकि उन्होंने ISA को बनाने में काफी अहम भूमिका निभाई थी. ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन गाइस. क्वेश्चन इज consider the following statement with respect to ISA and identify the correct statement. So the Paris Declaration established ISA as an alliance dedicated to promote solar energy among its member countries. Yes, it is headquartered at Gurugram. Yes, and countries that do not fall within the tropics can join the ISA and enjoy all benefits along with voting rights. No, unko voting rights nahi mila hai, unke paas voting rights nahi hai. So option jo statement 3 hamara, that will be incorrect. So the correct answer will be what guys? Option C, 1 and 2 only. And now question number 2, which is also based on this news. What is correct about the main move that would be taken in the first World Solar Technology Summit of ISA that is scheduled to be held on 8th September 2020? So these two statements are here and we have to find the correct statement. It would bring the spotlight on technologies for harnessing solar energy more efficiently. Yes. And IJOS, ISA journal would be launched to help authors from across the globe to publish their articles. Yes, so both the statements are absolutely correct. So therefore, the correct answer will be what, guys? Option C, 1 and 2, both are correct. And now let's move on to question number 3, which is about the Swadeshi Microprocessor Challenge Innovate Solutions for Atmanirbhar Bharat. This was launched by Ministry of Electronics and IT, headed by Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. His Lok Sabha constituency is Patna Sahib. Okay, his Lok Sabha constituency is what? Patna Sahib. So the question is, what are the names of these microprocessors jinke liye ye Swadeshi Microprocessor Challenge launch kiya gaya hai? Okay, so let us first discuss about this news. So Ministry of Electronics and IT launched this Swadeshi Microprocessor Challenge Innovate Solutions for Atmanirbhar Bharat, which seeks to invite innovators, startups, students and other stakeholders to use indigenously developed microprocessors Shakti and Vega to develop various technology products. Shakti और Vega microprocessors का इस्तेमाल करते हुए various technology products बनाने के लिए ये जो challenge है, ये invite करता है innovators को, startups को और students को, ताकि वो इन microprocessors का इस्तेमाल कर सके to develop various technology products. And these two microprocessors, Shakti and Vega, were developed by IIT Madras and CDAC under the aegis of Microprocessor Development Program of Ministry of Electronics and IT. And there is one more microprocessor, jiska naam hai Ajit, that was launched by IIT Bombay. Okay. And under this challenge, guys, internship opportunities and regular technical guidance will be provided to the participants. And also there is a provision of business mentorship and funding support for developing the hardware prototype. Okay. And कुछ awards भी हैं इसमें. So 100 semi-finalists will win total rupees 1 crore of award. 25 finalists will win rupees 1 crore of award. And top 10 teams जो होंगी entering the finale will get the seed fund of rupees 2.30 crores and 12 months incubation support. जो top 10 finale team होगी उनको seed fund दिया जाएगा. Seed fund का मतलब initial funding कह सकते हैं. Seed fund का मतलब होता है initial funding. So they will be provided initial funding of rupees 2.30 crores and 12 महीने का incubation support provide कराया जाएगा. Incubation support का मतलब है कि उनको digital infrastructure provide कराया जाएगा ताकि वो अपने जो prototypes हैं उनको एक proper products में convert कर सकें. Okay. And what will be the significance of this move? So it will meet India's future requirements of strategic and industrial sectors. It will mitigate the issues of security, licensing, technology obsolescence. And it will cut dependency on import. So these are the significance, and this is the image of Shakti microprocessor. बिल्कुल इसके जैसा ही देखने वाले एक अजीत microprocessor है जिसको launch किया था IIT Bombay ने. Okay. So this was about this news, guys. So the correct answer therefore is what? Shakti and Vega. And इसमें से एक question भी पूछा जा सकता है. Both of these microprocessor was launched by which IIT? So IIT Madras will be the correct answer. And अजीत का नाम भी याद रखेंगे. That was developed by IIT Bombay. And now let's move on to question number 4, which is about the Dhanvantri Rath. So the question is very simple. What is Dhanvantri Rath? Okay. So guys, Dhanvantri Rath, basically, ye kya hai? Ye ek mobile unit hai. And ek MOU sign hua hai between the All India Institute of Ayurveda and Delhi Police for extending the Ayurveda preventive and promotive health services in the residential colonies of Delhi Police through these mobile units, jinka naam hai Dhanvantri Rath. Okay. इससे पहले आप सबको याद होगा एक आयु रक्षा प्रोग्राम एक स्टार्ट किया गया था इन द मंथ ऑफ मई 2020 फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग आयुर्वेदा प्रिवेंटिव एंड प्रोमोटिव हेल्थ सर्विसेज टू द दिल्ली पुलिस पर्सोनल. बट नाउ दिस प्रोग्राम विल बी एक्सटेंडेड टू द फैमिलीज ऑफ द दिल्ली पुलिस पर्सोनल थ्रू दीज मोबाइल यूनिट वैन जिनका नाम है Dhanvantri Rath. ओके. सो दिस इनिशिएटिव गाइज इज इन द लाइन विद आयु रक्षा इनिशिएटिव विच इज अ जॉइंट वेंचर ऑफ AIIA, All India Institute of Ayurveda and Delhi Police. And in continuation of this project, these preventive and promotive healthcare will now be provided to the families of Delhi Police personnel with the help of these mobile units jinka naam hai Dhanvantri Rath. And these mobile units would consist a team of doctors who would be visiting Delhi Police colonies regularly. Okay. So if you talk about Ayu Raksha, so humne pad liya that this was launched in the month of May 2020 or Delhi Police को ये आयुर्वेदा से रिलेटेड सभी चीजें प्रोवाइड करने के लिए था ताकि वो कोविड-19 से लड़ाई कर सके और उनकी इम्यूनिटी को बूस्ट किया जा सके. एंड इसकी परफॉर्मेंस अच्छी थी बिकॉज आफ्टर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग आयु रक्षा किट्स टू नियरली 80,000 पुलिस पर्सनल इन दिल्ली इसको अब एक्सटेंड करा जा रहा है टू द फैमिलीज ऑफ दिल्ली पुलिस पर्सनल ऑल्सो. ओके. सो बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स गुड परफॉर्मेंस इट इज नाउ बीन एक्सटेंडेड टू द फैमिलीज ऑफ द दिल्ली पुलिस पर्सनल. राइट. सो गाइज देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी वॉट a mobile unit to provide Ayurveda services in the residential colonies of Delhi Police. Option A will be the correct answer. I hope guys aapko ye question kiya hai and there are no doubts. And now let's move on to question number 5, which is the last question for today. सो रिसेंटली जो एनजीटी है उसने कुछ स्टेट्स को गाइडलाइंस दी है, कुछ डायरेक्शन दी है टू पीरियोडिकली मॉनिटर द रेजुविनेशन ऑफ गंगा. सो द क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट अमंग दोज स्टेट्स. ओके सो लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट दिस. सो गंगा रेजुविनेशन मॉनिटरिंग इज द न्यूज एंड एनजीटी हैज ऑब्जर्व दैट द पॉल्यूटेंट्स आर स्टिल बीइंग डिस्चार्ज्ड इनटू द गंगा डिस्पाइट सेवरल डायरेक्शन ऑफ वेरियस कोर्ट्स एंड देर आर फोर स्टेट्स उत्तर प्रदेश, उत्तराखंड, बिहार एंड वेस्ट बंगाल. These states have failed in preventing discharge of untreated effluents in violation of provision of the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act of 1974. ये जो act है इसका year आपको याद रखना बहुत जरूरी है guys. ये directly पूछा जा सकता है. What is the enactment year of the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act? So the year is 1974 and इस act के जो provisions हैं उसको violate करते हुए ये जो चार स्टेट्स हैं उत्तराखंड, बिहार, उत्तर प्रदेश एंड वेस्ट बंगाल, ये सभी के सभी फेल हो गए हैं इन प्रिवेंटिंग डिस्चार्ज ऑफ अनट्रीटेड एफ्लुएंट्स इन द रिवर गंगा. एंड कुछ डायरेक्शन दिए गए हैं बाय एनजीटी. सो एनजीटी हैज डायरेक्टेड द अबव स्टेट्स टू पीरियोडिकली मॉनिटर द रेजुविनेशन ऑफ गंगा एंड एनजीटी हैज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड फॉर पीरियोडिक जॉइंट मीटिंग्स ऑफ द अबव स्टेट्स टू कंसीडर सम इश्यूज लाइक पूलिंग ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज, शेयरिंग बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस फॉर रेजुविनेशन ऑफ गंगा and preventing discharge of sewage and other pollutants in Ganga directly or through its tributaries or drains connected thereto. Okay, so these are some directions that were given by NGT to these states. And if you talk about guys NGT, so it was set up under the NGT Act of 2010. It is headquartered in New Delhi. Ye New Delhi mein hai and it is headed by Justice A.K. Goyal, Adarsh Kumar Goyal. He is the chairperson of NGT. And India was the third country in the world to have a specialized environmental tribunal after Australia and New Zealand. And India was the first developing country to do so. And NGT aims at disposal of cases related to environmental protection and conservation of forest and other natural resources. All right. So therefore, guys, the correct answer should be what? Which of the following is not among those states? So Jharkhand is not one among them. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option E, Jharkhand. Okay guys, so that's it for the session today. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. And for more sessions like this, do buy our paid courses of RBI, SEBI, NABARD and UGC NET. Thank you so much for watching. Aapko ye session kaisa laga? Comment karke zarur bataye. Goodbye, take care and God bless.